So dear students, yesterday we have started chapter Reach for the Top. We were reading about Santosh Yadav. Okay, so we came to know about her childhood. How was her childhood? Which kind of girl she was when she was a child? How did she aspire for her future? How did she make plan for that? So yesterday we have gone through only first and second paragraph, and from that we have come to know about that society where she took birth. Okay, so that was such kind of orthodox society where boys were given so much importance and girls were not given importance. So when her mother was expecting and there was a holy man, there was one saint, so he thought that they would definitely ask for the wishes that lady should be blessed with the son. But on the contrary, what happened? That lady, she did not, and her Santosh mother and Santosh grandmother, they told holy man that they did not expect any boy. They expected what kind of blessings? To bless them with a girl. So holy man, he got so surprised, because at that time in society everybody wanted to have son, nobody wanted to have a daughter. So in second paragraph we have come to know that very beautiful name Santosh was given to her, because the meaning of Santosh is satisfaction, contentment. But her personality was not like that, because she was not contented, she was not satisfied what she was having. Why so? Because such kind of rules and regulations were imposed on some of the people and she was not able to follow those rules. She was going against them. Why so? Because she thought that why girls are given that task that they should always wear those traditional Hindu dresses like ghagra, choli and like that. Why she couldn't wear shorts? So she was wearing that. She was wearing that because she was not following that obsolete and traditional method. She did not want to go for that. She did not want to follow it. Okay. So Santosh parents, they were so affluent, you can say, they were so wealthy, so they could afford very easily to send her daughter to, you can say, New Delhi or for higher study to another city, to another country. They could afford it easily. Okay, so when she was living in Haryana, okay, and she had to follow the prevailing, you can say, custom in the family. So she decided to fight with that system, and she thought that she should live her life in her own way. So what happened at the age of 16, she had to make up her mind. She had to make a firm decision when girls of her age, she, you can say, were getting, when the girls of her age, they were getting married, and she was also supposed to do the same, but she opposed that system. She said this thing that no, she did not want to get married at the age of 16. She wanted to, you can say, go against that. She was so much under pressure from her parents to do same, that she should get married. But she did not, because she was having some desires, some ambitions, some goals in her life, and she wanted to pursue for that. She wanted to go for higher studies. She wanted to leave that place. Okay, she wanted to make her own identity. And how did she face all the problem? Because there were so many hurdles and obstacles. But that life, you can say, the family, the society where she was living, the town and city where she was living, there were hard and fast custom and traditions. Girls were not given so much importance. Okay, so how did she face all these problems? This is all about the chapter. So let's go through paragraph number 4. So who is going to read? Aparan, you read 4th paragraph. Afterwards, I will be explaining to you. Come here. So Aparan will be reading 4th paragraph. Listen carefully. Afterwards, I will be explaining to you.
A marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. Wishing always to study a bit more, and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed high school examinations and went to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel faced her Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. One day I decided to check it out myself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. I asked if I could join them. To my pleasant surprise, they answered in an affirmative and motivated me to take the climbing.
So from paragraph number 4, we have come to know that marriage, okay, at a very early age, you can say at the age of 16, girls of her town, city, area, they were supposed to get married, okay? So marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. So she spoke like that you are only having that mission in your mind that I should get married, okay? So she threatened her parents. It means made her parents afraid that she would never marry, because she wanted to have proper education first. She wanted to be educated. She wanted to be literate. Okay. So for her, marriage was not of having any importance. First priority she wanted to give to education. Okay. So she opposed her parents by saying that first of all, she wanted to be literate. She wanted to get education. So that's why she left home, because in Haryana, so many good schools were not available at that time for higher studies. So that's why she had to leave that place, and she got herself enrolled. Enrolled means she got admission. So write down the meaning of enrolled. Enrolled means she got admission. So she admitted herself in a very good school of New Delhi, okay? And when she went there, she got admission in that. See, the very first obstacle, hurdle that she has to face, her parents refused to pay her fees. See, parents were so wealthy, so rich. They could afford that fees very easily. But she went against her parents. She went in Delhi, enrolled herself, took admission in that college, okay? So parents said, no, we are not going to pay your fees. Isn't it strange? See, because she opposed her parents. Parents were saying that you should get married. She said only marriage is in your mind. Marriage is only the first and the last goal in your life. That you are insisting me to get married again and again. Why so? Because I want to go for higher studies. I want to make my career. I want to get education first of all. So that's why she did not obey her parents. And she went to Delhi for higher education. She enrolled herself. It means she got admission also. But parents, they did not pay her fees. Okay. So she very politely informed them that she would be earning money. For that fees, she would be working part-time. Because she couldn't join any, you can say, job. Because in job, she was required to work for morning to evening. She couldn't work for morning to evening because she had to study also. She was getting admission. She got admission in college. So that's why she thought that she should go for part-time so that she could earn money and she could spend that money on her fees. Clear? So that was her luck, that she was born with a very rich parents, but she had to pay her college fee on her own. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. But when such kind of information was given to her parents, so after finally her parents agreed, okay, there is no need to go for part-time. We are ready to pay your fees. Parents became sympathetic that their daughter should not work for part-time. How would she manage? How would she cope up? How would she make balance? Because it's very difficult to work as well as to study at both time simultaneously. Okay. Wishing always to study a bit more and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed the high school examination and went to Jaipur. See, her father also wished this thing that she should study a bit more, because when such kind of desire was told by Santosh, she has got education from New Delhi. Now she wanted to have more education. So that was her urge. Urge means that was her desire. So when her father came to know about this desire, about this urge that she wanted to have little bit more education and she wanted to go for that education to Jaipur. So her father, he had to agree. He had to agree. Okay. So for that, she joined Maharani College, okay? And there was Kasturba Hostel. She went into that, she got a room in that, and she shifted to Jaipur. She was living in that hostel for getting little bit more education, clear, in that hostel. So when she was living in that Kasturba Hostel, she was facing Aravali Hills. See, from there she got her mission, what she wanted to be in her life. Very beautiful chapter. You people will enjoy if you go through each and every line of the chapter. Now she got education from New Delhi. Now she has shifted to where? Jaipur. Where was she living? In Kasturba Hostel. So from Kasturba Hostel, what was visible? Aravali Hills. So when she was looking at Aravali Hills, she used to watch so many villagers from her room. Okay. Those villagers, they were going up the hill, and when they were climbing up the hill, all of a sudden they were vanishing. What is the meaning of vanishing? Write down the meaning of vanishing. Vanishing means disappearing. They were disappearing. It means the people, villagers, they were climbing up the Aravali Hill. But after some time, those people were not to be seen. They were disappeared. They got vanished. Okay. So first of all, she thought that she should go and check why those people were vanishing. So I found nobody except a few mountaineers. Okay. So she found that some of the people, they were climbing on the mountains. Okay. So she asked those people if she could join them. Okay. So it was really a surprise, very pleasant surprise for her, that their answer was in affirmative. It means they gave a positive response. Affirmative means they did not say no. They spoke in a very positive, yes, if you want to join us, no problem, you can come and join us. Okay. And they also motivated her to climb on the mountains. Okay. So when she started climbing on the mountains along with them, after that, there was no, you can say, looking back. It means now she got her mission. Afterwards, she did not look back. She was just climbing and climbing and climbing. It means she got her mission that what is her goal in her life, that she wanted to become a mountaineer. She wanted to become a mountaineer. So there was no looking back for his determined young girl. She was a young girl. She has a fixed determination in her mind. She was having a very clear goal in her life. Now she started saving money. Okay? She started saving money and she got admission in a course at Uttarkashi Nehru's Institute of Mountaineering. She got admission in Uttarkashi's Institute, Nehru's Institute. Okay. So my college semester in Jaipur was to end in April, but it ended on the 19th of May. So she, earlier, where was she studying? In college. And her semester was about to be over in the month of April, but it ended in the month of May. Okay. So after that, on 21st, she was supposed to go at Uttarkashi. Okay. And after that, she did not go back home. Instead, she went there to have a training for climbing mountains. Okay. So for that, she had to write down an apology letter. What is apology letter? Yes. Because after sorry letter. Yes. Because after completing that course in Jaipur, she was supposed to go back home. This permission was given by her father. But when she was attracted towards climbing mountains, she started saving money and she took admission in that college, Nehru College. Okay. So after that, she wrote a letter, apology letter to her father. Okay, because without taking their permission, she enrolled herself in Uttarkashi. Okay, because now she made up her mind that she wanted to go for that mission. She wanted to make her career in that line. Up to that clear? Now, Reza, you come and read 7th paragraph.
Santosh went on an expedition.
Speak loudly.
Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly. Also, she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. Equipped with an iron will, education, endurance, and amazing mental toughness, she proved herself repeatedly. The culmination of her hard work and sincerity came in 1992. Just 4 years after, she had shyly asked the Aravali Mountaineers if she could join them. At barely 20 years of age, Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. In her climbing skills, physical fitness, and mental strength impressed her seniors. Her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the heart of fellow climbers.
So when she enrolled herself in that Uttarkashi Institute, so thereafter she was going on expedition. What is the meaning of expedition? Can anybody tell me that the meaning of expedition? Yes. So the meaning of expedition is
journey.
Journey. So she was going on that journey. Every year she was given a chance to climb on the mountains. So with a practice, her skills were, you can say, improving. Her skills matured rapidly. It means she became expert in that. By doing a lot of practice, by climbing on the mountains every year, so her skills were maturing. It means she was becoming proficient in that, and that's why she developed a remarkable resistance to cold. Resistance. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of resistance? Resistant means opposition. Opposition. It means when she was climbing on mountains, so that too cold, there was a cold weather, altitude you can say, height, write down the meaning side by side, only then you'll be able to understand the text. So there was height, there was cold, so she has to oppose them. It means she has to fight with all these obstacles. So she got resistance for such kind of hurdles. You got that? Resistance means opposition. So when one has to go on that level, they have to fight with such kind of problems. Cold can be there, height can be there. We all are afraid of such kind of things, isn't it? So she developed such kind of stamina to develop a resistance for such kind of problem. And besides that, she was having a iron will. Iron will means strong willpower. Only not by doing physical hardship, physical labor, one can face such kind of problem. One should have the iron willpower also, that stamina also, physical endurance. Endurance, you can say, what is the meaning of endurance? Endurance means tolerance. One should have the physical tolerance also for that. Okay. And besides that, one should have the mental toughness. It means mentally you should be strong. Because to reach on the mountain, it doesn't require only physical stamina. It requires so many other things also. Willpower should be strong. Your emotional skills should be there. You should have a tolerance. You should have a such kind of mental toughness. Or by doing all the things, she was proving herself with lots of stamina. And the culmination of her hard work. What is the meaning of culmination? No. Culmination means top, summit. Summit means top. You can use zenith word also for that. Yes. So the culmination of her hard work, it means her hard work was at top. She was having other skills also, but her hard work was at the top. It was at the zenith. Because of that sincerity, all these things came forward in which year? In 1992. And after that, after 4 years, she had shyly asked the arriving mountaineers if she could join them. Because there were so many people, so many mountaineers who were climbing on Aravali Hill. So when she gathered all these things in herself, she accumulated hard work, you can say resistance to overcome all these cold and altitude. Okay, she was having that desire to go there. She was having that balance. She got all these qualities. So near about for working hard for near about 4 years, she shyly means having not proper courage. She was feeling shy in front of so many mountaineers. She asked them, could she join them? Okay. So at the age of 20 years, Santosh Yadav, she finally scaled. She reached Mount Everest. She reached Mount Everest. okay, and she was the youngest woman in the world to achieve that feat. Feat means height. Okay, so because of her climbing skills, because of her fitness, physical fitness, because of her mental health, all these things really impressed the seniors. Seniors were so impressed to see her skills and her concern for other also, and her ability to work together. She was not scaling only on that place. She went along with other persons, other climbers. Okay, so really, because she wanted to work for others, she wanted to work with others. Okay, so that was a special place in the hearts of fellow climbers, because she did not want to attain that goal only. Other climbers were also going with her, so she accompanied them. Okay, she took help from them, she gave them help also. So all these things were really praiseworthy. Seniors were so impressed to see her zeal, see her enthusiasm to reach on the top. Clear? So for zeal, you can write down the word enthusiasm. Zeal, another word is fervor. So zeal, enthusiasm, fervor, all these words you can write down. So I'm going to stop share for a while so that you can look, online students can look at the blackboard and they can jot down these difficult words and they can learn it thoroughly. By the time I mark your attendance, Dhiren, Ikjot, Jayati, Kriti Verma, Mitansh, Parmeet. Okay, you have got a time to talk. Mitansh, Parmeet, Ridhima, Sudiksha, Sumati, Aryan Chopra. Ninth, hey, what happened in your class? You can go through the text. By that I'm taking attendance. You people have started talking. So now finally she became the first youngest woman to climb Mount Everest. Okay. So during 1992 Everest mission, 1992 Everest mission was going on, and Santosh Yadav, she was given special care. She provided, special care to a climber. Why so? Because when she was busy on her mission, on her way, she saw that there was a South Colonel. It is COL written. COL is a short form of, spellings are this, but pronunciation is Colonel. Okay, so she was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. On her way, when she found that person, but she was not able to save that person, but she managed herself to save the life of another climber. What was the name of another climber? It was Mohan Singh. Okay, because that Mohan Singh could meet with her fate, it means could meet with her destiny. It means he could die at any moment if she had not saved that person by providing her own oxygen. She was having oxygen. She shared that oxygen with that person. So in this way, she saved the life of Mohan Singh. So it means how nice she was on her way. She was not thinking about only and only her mission. She wanted to reach at the zenith, at the top, by helping other companions who were also on that mission. Clear? So within 12 years, Santosh was in the team of Indo-Nepalese Women's Expedition. It is written WOMEN. What is its correct pronunciation? Women. If A is there, it is women. But if plural is there, so its pronunciation will be women. You were aware of this thing?
Yes, ma'am.
How many? You were aware of this thing?
Yes, ma'am.
That it was women?
Yes, ma'am.
That's good. So its right pronunciation is women. That is their smartness, no problem. I want my all students should come to know about correct pronunciation. That's why I asked. So it is women. Speak it 5 times. So within 12 months, she found herself in a team of Indo-Nepalese Women's Expedition. Okay, and that expedition, that journey, that team, they invited Santosh Yadav to join them. So after that, she was climbing on Mount Everest second time, and now she had made a record because she was the only woman who have reached on Mount Everest two times. And now she got a very unique place in the history of India, in the history of mountaineering. Okay. Now her achievements were recognized and Indian government bestowed upon means awarded her one of the nation's top honor. What was that? Padma Shri. What was that? Padma Shri award was given to that. Okay, so such award was given to her. So this was all her achievement at a very young age. She is really. So up to that, we are able to read that chapter up to 9th paragraph. So you have holiday tomorrow. You find out these answers and we will be discussing these question answers on Saturday. You should have plenty of ideas. Notes should be with you. Content quality should be very much up to the mark. So you all should be very much eager to tell me the answer. Okay.